I know to a lot of you newcomers in bodybuilding, nutrition seems complicated and mysterious. It's not. Bodybuilding nutrition is simple if you take a top-down approach. In this video, I'm going to show you how. A lot of the confusion that people have is that they get conflicting advice. You should do this, you should do that, and it doesn't fit into a big picture. In this video, I'm going to give you the big picture so you can design your own excellent bodybuilding nutritional plan. A bodybuilding nutritional plan is very similar to a personal financial budget. It's about making difficult choices and sticking to them. And in both cases, the risk of blowing the budget is disaster. In financial terms, you could end up with a mountain of debt and credit cards that you can never escape from. And with your nutrition, you can end up either fat or weak. Neither is what we want. In a financial plan, you start with your monthly income and then subtract out the things that you gotta pay, like taxes, rent, car payments, things like that. A nutritional plan is very similar. What you do is you start out with how many calories you can have a day and then subtract out the things that are important first and see what you got left over for your cheat meals. So let's look at how easy it is to do this top-down nutritional planning. Number one, you figure out with a calorie calculator how many calories your body burns off a day. Number two, you figure out what you want your daily caloric budget to be. You might be running a deficit if you want to lose fat and get ripped. You might be a surplus if you want to bulk. So step two is to determine what your calorie target is for the day. Number three is to determine your macros. What that means is what percent of your calories you want from protein, what percent you want from carbohydrate, and what percent you want from fat. Step four is to multiply those out and figure out how many grams of protein, how many grams of carbohydrate, and how many grams of fat you get per day. That's your budget. You've got to stick within that. Now that we have our budget, let's start subtracting the important things out that are required for gaining muscle. We're going to start with fruits and vegetables. Vitamins are really important. So we're going to add 3 pieces of fruit and 4 to 6 cups of vegetables. The next thing we're going to subtract out is fiber. Fiber is very important not only for health, but to help us fill ourselves up with fewer calories so we're less likely to binge. We need 40 grams of fiber in our day. So figure out what you have in your fruits and vegetables, and the rest you're going to get from either whole grains or beans. So go ahead and add the whole grains and legumes to get the fiber you need. Next up, we're going to add a food to get omega-3 fatty acids. These are really important for gaining muscle as well as for cardiovascular health. So typically that's going to be from fish, a cold water fish. So go ahead and put that into your budget. Next, obviously, is protein. That's very important. So there's going to be some possible protein in the other items we've already added. So subtract that out, and the rest add your main protein source. It can be beef, chicken, whatever have you. But total everything up, because you're going to make sure you're going to stay within your budget. Last of all, we're going to add good fats. We're going to add unsaturated fats like olives and nuts, and we're going to use 10% of our calories. So go ahead and add that into your budget. Now we're going to add some good saturated fat. We don't want any more than 10% of our total calories to be from saturated fat, but you're going to want to go ahead and add in some good things like eggs, etc. Now, subtract everything from your budget and see what you have left over. That's what you can use for cheat meals. Okay, let's take an example so you can see how this is going to work. Let's take a hypothetical 160-pound person who's 25 years old, 68 inches tall. They do 3 to 5 hours a week of cardio, and their energy consumption per day. In this case, our goal is losing weight, so we're going to have a 20% caloric deficit. That means 2176 calories a day is our goal. Next, we need to choose our macros. In this example, we're going to use 30% protein, 40% carbs, and 30% fat. Now we need to multiply that out to find out how much protein, carbs, and fat we get a day. So 30% of our 2176 calories is 653 calories. That means 163 grams of protein. 40% of our calories is 870 calories per day, so that means 217 grams of carbs. 30% of our calories, again, is 653 calories, so we get 72 grams of fat for the day. Now we're ready to go. Let's start with vegetables and fruits, because we need those all-important vitamins to help us build muscles. We're going to have 3 to 5 pieces of fruit and 4 to 6 cups of veggies. At the top of the chart, you see our daily goals, and at the bottom of the chart, you see how many grams are left that we need of each of the items listed. Okay, now we're going to add enough whole grains to get the fiber we need. In this case, it's a cup of rolled oats. To get those all-important omega-3 fatty acids, which are very important for adding muscle, we're going to have 250 grams of salmon. Now we're going to add our protein source. You'll notice at this point we've already added a lot of protein through the other items, so we only need 67 grams of protein, and we're going to get that from grilled chicken. Now to get our good fats, we're going to have 1 ounce of nuts, 3 ounces of olives, that's for unsaturated fat, and for a saturated fat we're going to have 1 egg. You'll notice what's left now is just 29 grams of carbs and 8 grams of fat. What'll that get you? That's half a Snickers bar. That's not much of a cheat meal.
So there you have it. Bodybuilding nutrition does not have to be complicated if you take a top-down approach, just as you would with a financial budget. You start with how much you have to spend, that's a number of calories, subtract out the things that are really important for gaining muscle. Whatever is left over after that, you can use for cheat meals. Now, there's a lot more wiggle room when you're maintaining your weight or bulking than there is when you're cutting. As you saw from the example, when you're cutting, you do not have much leeway at all. Every single calorie counts. But that's not always the case. As again, I said, if you're bulking or maintaining, you have a lot more leeway. So that's honestly why I don't bulk and cut, because for every week you spend at a 20% surplus in calories, you have to be at a 20% caloric deficit to lose that fat. That's a lot of work, and I don't like work. Auf Wiedersehen.